Have you heard about the Harper government's plan to replace the Long Gun Registry with a new registry that will come from the implementation of the MintChip?
No, what is a MintChip?
It is a digital currency that allows users to load monetary value onto a secure chip.
What is monetary value? Is it the same as money?
No. Monetary value can be anything that is considered to have value within a monetary system, including debt.
You mean the mint chip could also track what I owe?
Sure. It can also enable the government to keep track of every purchase you make.
Don't we usually get air miles or something for that?
Yes, but only when it's the private sector tracking your purchases. The government can do it for free.
Does this mean the government can track every gun I buy even though they have gotten rid of the Long Gun Registry?
Yes.
And keep track of the bullets I buy for my gun?
Yes.
And keep track of the gun club memberships and gun licenses I buy?
Yes.
Doesn't this mean they can actually keep track of more information about me than when they had the Long Gun Registry?
Yes.
Does the mint chip mean they can also track other things I do?
Yes.
Will they be able to track what prescription drugs I buy?
Yes.
And track the transit I take or where I pay to park my car?
Yes.
But doesn't this mean that Prime Minister Harper would be in the bedroom of every Canadian?
Yes.
Doesn't this mean that the government will be able to know almost everything about me?
Yes. In fact, there would be enough information to build a complete personal profile which, when combined with your social insurance number, driver's license, health card and passport would render you a virtual electronic prisoner, unable to do anything that requires an exchange within the monetary system, or money as we used to say, without the government knowing about it.
I thought that Harper's conservative government was against big government with lots of regulations and oversight.
Yes, that is what they say.
Wouldn't this new mint chip result in the mother of all oversight?
Yes. It would mean that the Harper government would be building the mother of all personal information registries that would make the Long Gun Registry look like a drop in the bucket.
Doesn't that mean a complete lack of privacy?
Yes.
Wasn't there a time when our money was actually worth something like gold or silver?
Yes. In fact, the penny is the last coin we have that is actually worth what it is supposed to be worth because it is made out of copper. A penny is actually made out of about a penny's worth of copper.
Isn't the Harper government getting rid of the penny?
Yes. Inflation has rendered a penny's worth to be too small to count, so we are getting rid of it.
How much is a Canadian loonie or toonie worth now?
It's hard to say. Probably about a penny because they are made out of plated steel, not the gold or silver they are made to look like. They used to be made of bronze-plated nickel, which would have more value than plated steel.
How much would a mint chip be worth?
Probably zero because there isn't any inherent value in the binary number system's two binary digits, 0 and 1.
How many binary zeros and ones that represent loonies would Harper's government create?
No one knows. The Harper government would have to decide in how many binary zeros and ones are in a plated steel loonie and go from there.
How many binary zeros and ones would my house be worth?
No one knows. I guess the Harper government would have to discuss this with your bank and together they would decide in how many binary zeros and ones your house is worth.
Will the mint chip make it easier for me to file my taxes?
Yes, it should. In fact, they may even get rid of annual income tax filing because they will already have all the information about how many mint chips you earned and how you earned them. And they will already have all the information about how many mint chips you spent and what you spent them on.
Will the mint chip make paying my taxes easier?
Yes, it should because the Harper government could automatically debit your mint chip account for the taxes you owe.
Was the mint chip designed by Orwell, the author of the futuristic novel with Big Brother watching over us?
I'm not sure.
What does the Harper government say about the possible privacy implications?
The Harper government says that the mint chip will not contain information about you.
Is that true?
No. The mint chip is just binary zeros and ones which are meaningless without the secure chip that will hold them. So it's a half-truth, because the whole truth is that the card or whatever holds the mint chips will have to contain information about you, otherwise it couldn't keep track of how many mint chips you have, and it would not know when you have used up all your mint chips. So it would have to contain banking information about you and what you have spent. It's not the same as having money in your wallet. When your wallet is empty, it's empty. No technology or personal information is needed to do the math.
So let me get this straight. The Harper government says they believe in less bureaucratic red tape and oversight to promote economic growth and jobs, but they are planning to implement electronic surveillance of all financial transactions, even tiny transactions like buying a candy bar. They will get rid of the cash economy by getting rid of the cash.
Yes.
They call this strategy mint chips.
Yes.
And they say that mint chips will make it easier for us, the average consumer, to buy things.
Yes.
And although there were lots of election issues, making it easier to spend money and buy stuff wasn't an election issue.
No, it was not.
And even though there are lots of ways for the Harper government to spend taxpayers' money, they plan to spend it on ways to track what and where we spend our own money.
Yes.
Will the mint chips create lots of new jobs?
No.
Will the mint chips improve the healthcare system?
No.
Will the mint chip improve education?
No.
Will the mint chips improve the environment?
No.
Will the mint chips help us look after the aging population?
No.
Will the mint chips cost taxpayers money to implement?
Yes.
Was the mint chip part of the Harper government selection platform?
No.
Then why are they doing it?
Because they have a majority government now and they can do whatever they want. And what they want is to track all financial transactions, get rid of all cash transactions, and become more efficient at collecting taxes.
Why do they want to do this?
Because when you think you can do whatever you want to make sure you have enough money to do it.
What else do you think they will want to do?
Well, judging by what they are already doing with Canada's oil and gas resources, I would guess they will want to sell Canada's fresh water to the highest bidder. But first they will have to decide how many mint chips it is worth and transfer that value onto a digital device to make the selling of Canada's water more efficient and easier to do.
Will we have to buy a special government-issued digital device to buy our water, electricity, gas and other necessities?
We will have to wait and see what the Harper government has in store for us next. Everything is on a need-to-know basis and we are only Canadian citizens, so Harper is probably asking himself, do we really need to know?
He seems to do a lot of things behind closed doors. The last time I looked, Canada was still a democracy, wasn't it?
Yes, let's hope it still is when Harper gets through with it.